Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds, Murder on Eridanos, Blind. We gotta talk to the chef, and someone on a balcony, among other things. So, I wonder what the banging around is.
What floor would you like to visit?
The lobby, please. Alright. Someone on the balcony. Oh, it's actually outside. Alright, so where's the chef then? He's not outside, so let me just check this to see if there's any new entries here. We must find the chef. Oh. We weren't able to get back here before. It's down here. Who's down here?
I hope you catch the killer soon, Inspector. I don't want to see the Grand Colonial shut down.
Oh, wow.
Something mighty strange went on earlier.
What happened? Norville get his cap stuck in the toilet again?
Not today. I was carrying a bag up to the second VIP guest floor. Even for our guests, it was spectacularly heavy.
Wow, exciting.
I wasn't finished. I took a bad step and dropped it. Know what spilled out? Rocks. Whoever owned it was just making me carry it around for fun.
Nice hat.
No, I'm sorry. We don't serve any drinks with those tiny umbrellas.
I said nice hat.
Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
All this stuff is stealing. Notice of promotion. Congratulations, employee and or addressee. You have been rewarded one free tour of the Rizzo's Distillation and Libation Station. Wow. As a reward for logging in at least 10,000 hours of service to the Rizzo's family. As you take your first sip of your choice of Rizzo Spectrum Vodka, remember to take a moment to experience gratitude. No gratitude for you. Remember. You got the Golden Eagles. You got something Golden Eagles. It's everything you've heard supposed to... You can almost read that. Almost. Oh, here's another one. Engineer job posting. Attention! The Grand Colonial Hotel is seeking a new volunteer engineer. Skills include elevator maintenance, electrical engineering, civil engineering, computer engineering, quantum engineering, knowing when to keep problems to oneself. The employee who accepts this position will be expected to carry out their existing duties of the hotel for no additional payment. Oh. How wonderful. Talk to your supervisor if interested during your 15-minute break. And don't forget, with more hours logged each week, the closer you get to winning the free tour. Wow. Don't do it. It's a ripoff. I hear, what do you call it? Sprats. Get that closed. I'm gonna steal stuff. As if I really need any more of those anyway. Look at that safe. That's interesting looking. Room B1 key card. A key to the room in the employee quarters section of the Grand Cathedral, made out of painted cardboard. So much for security. Huh. B1. Wait a second. We also got 66 bits. Cool. B1. This isn't B1, is it? Nope. Huh. Done in here. A. Oh. Goes to B1. Dead Sprats. Huh. Who killed the Sprats? Was it Chris Pratt? Come on in, guys. I gotta close this. I have enemies showing up. Well, this is pickup. I'm not stealing. What about the safe? Huh. On this thing. Oh, hacking skill too low. Of 100? What are you doing? Elite troop armor brings it down, but still, I need 100. If I take off the armor and get, you know, put something to increase, I think, mind skills? Or maybe it's dexterity? Even that won't be enough. Did you kill your friends? Rabid Sprat.
Here they come. That's how it's done, Captain.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna use this thing as a weapon. Whoa.
Their mistake.
Somehow I still get hide out of that. I don't know how that works. Not moving. Guys, is there something right there?
Make him regret. The last of them. They can't keep us out.
The what? Oh, you're big. And that's glass. Pap pills. So dark. Champion toss ball stick. What's that? Something I cannot get. A big thing is through here. Rat of unusual size, really? Jesus, this thing's tough! Yikes. Okay. Guilty by association. Got a bunch of stuff. Sprat of unusual size. Yeah, there's your Princess Bride reference. Okay, this stuff is mine. I earned it. I just now earned it. Something on top. That time I hit it by mistake. That was me. Pieces of it. Dead bellhop. I don't know if he kept a level head. Hotel guest. Right, this is that bard room. Schematics or something. Grand Colonial Hotel uniform. One armors, not too bad, huh? The uniform of a noble soldier in the never-ending war against poor hospitality and inadequate room service. That's funny. All right, what do we got here? Engineer's final note. To whom it may or may not concern, I don't understand why I deserved to be terminated. I was your engineer. I fixed things. Your time clock was malfunctioning. You were logging 1 hour for every 10 I put in. How is that fair? And yeah, I admit it, I wanted that free tour of the distillery. I put in my 10,000 hours, and I deserve to wet my throat with a little spectrum violet. I didn't know accepting that free tour meant I joined the Rizzo's family. You know I can't read fine print ever since that welding accident. I don't know what I'm supposed to do now. Catch a freighter back to the Groundbreaker? Subline won't pick me up. So I guess that means I'm going to go talk to Mr. Ludovico, hat in hand, and beg him to employ me. Sorry, I take that back. I won't have my hat in my hand. I turned that in with the rest of my personals. It was a stupid hat. Anyway, Mott. I like Mott. I am on his side. Team Mott. Alright. So that's C. These Sprats deserve the treatment here. Did she say mean? I'm trapped in room A3. Someone please come help me. B4. I wish I could turn the lights on in this place. Who puts their money right by the toilet? What room is this for again? This key. B1. This is B3. I'm feeling weak. Please just open the door. I'm not sure how much longer I'll make it.
Beep, beep, beep. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Okay. Electrocharged surface? What's an electrocharged surface? Ah! It's Tally! From Mass Effect. Tally, I'm sorry! I'm sorry. Alright. Alright. Electrocharged surface? Is it one of these? Oh, it is. It's an armor mod. Stuns and damages melee attackers. This effect has a cooldown. Applies an electrical charge to the armor's exterior, occasionally shocking the attacker who comes in contact with it. Yeah, I haven't messed with any of this stuff for quite a while. Alright, let's read this. Handwritten note. I have eaten the purple berries which were in the refrigerator and which you were probably saving for breakfast. They were awful. Who the note to? Whoever lives in this place? Or lived? B2. So wait. This is where the thing is? B1 it is, okay. Oh, there's a thing in here. Don't mess with us. Removed wall panel. This wall panel has been removed. Judging by the scorch marks on the sides and the blowtorch abandoned on the floor, its removal does not conform to company guidelines. Oh, I would think not. I would think it wouldn't conform to guidelines. What is that? Like another schematic or something? Spectrum Brown. It's a new one. Haha, that one floated in air. I took the bottom one first. Look at that. Pepperberry punch. Big wooden box. Oh, this is B1. I guess what we got in here anyway. Thunderclap. More Spectrum Brown. Oh, wow. Unused poster. More Spectrum Brown. Well, I kept a bunch of it here, along with promotional materials. And a parasite. Oh, forgot that. I didn't see that. Can't forget something that you don't even see, right? Janitor's private diary. Dear diary, my new living quarters are real swell, but I'm having a bit of trouble getting to sleep every night. Management kindly offered to board me up in the hallway while they commandeer my room for Spectrum launch storage. Since then, I've been seeing things. Now I... because of that parasite. Now I'm sure it's due to lack of sleep on account of the darned leaky pipe above my bed, but last night I saw something like a giant worm slither past me. Now don't get me wrong, and I'm entirely grateful over all the space I now have, but I have to find a way to get some rest before I go completely mad. Completely mad. I'm killing them all. There's one in here. There another one in here? I know. Kind of ironic using this huge thing. That terminal really bothers me. Alright, so we're in A. I don't remember which the ghostly noise was coming from. Work IDs of Helen's sidekicks. This pile of cartridges contains the IDs of Halcyon Helen's sidekicks who were killed, mortally wounded, mulched, melted, torn to ribbons, decapitated, or turned into mechanicals in the line of duty, or otherwise identified post-mortem. Typhon Tim, Olympus Opal, Terra to Terry, Sparks the Wonder Canid, Burbage's 900 through 1999, Bolt Vander Huge, Eridanos Eve, Inconsequential Groundbreaker Maintenance Worker number 13B9, Caleb Bison, the broker with four broken limbs, Halifax, the entire 26th season of the Tile Backers, IDs Black and Beyond Individual Recognition, Stakeout Steve Dirk Tenderly. Okay. More stuff to examine. Okay. The spectacular and thrilling and great adventures of Alan Norville and Halcyon Helen, chapter 45/137. And because the ever resolute Lord Bellhop, Alan Norville, had brought his automatic Spacer's Choice auto pistol, now with added explosive ammo, which he held in his big muscular hands, the gigantic horde of rabid canids was all dead. Halcyon Helen, looking very beautiful as always, with her beautiful eyes and lips and nice shoes, she quickly grabbed Lord Bellhop Elaine Norville's hand. "Oh, thank you so much, Alan," she sighed slowly, batting her beautiful eyes at him also slowly. "You are the best partner I have ever teamed up with. You are so big and strong and good at shooting. I wish I had you with me from day one. Then maybe I would not have so many dead sidekicks." "It ain't no big deal, Purpleberry Cakes," chuckled Lord Bellhop Alan Norville as he took a puff from his cigarette and blew the smoke from the barrel of his Spacer's Choice auto pistol at the same time. "I am just a wandering assassin. Being good at shooting stuff is only because I am part of my job." "I'm part of my job?" "Yes, you are, and you are so handsome," sighed the beautiful Helen. "Thank you," chuckled Lord Bellhop Alan Norville. Can we just call him Alan? Just then they started to go for a kiss, but wait, just as the romance was about to happen, suddenly a hand had grabbed Alan's leg. Helen screams. Thank you for just calling him Alan. "It is me, the dissonant lord. I am here to get you. Capital G and Y, and take your bits and give them to everyone else for free," screams the dissonant lord as the villain began to crawl out of the dirt. His zombie army was also crawling to the surface behind him as well. "I guess there's only one thing to do," sneered the heroic Lord Bellhop as he took a big Hammersmith flamethrower out of his back pocket. He put a flamethrower out of his back pocket that he had been keeping secret for just this occasion. "Time to make some dissident steaks." Right. Shampoo bottle. Okay. Oh, he looked at that, right. Can't pick it up. Sorry if it's so dark for you guys.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Requires room A2 keycard to unlock. Didn't I see another? Wasn't there a discrepancy in? It's in the room. Wasn't there one in one of the other rooms? I might have missed, forgot. One, yes. Here. Frozen dinners. Huh.
selection of frozen food has not been restocked in some time. Many of these items are not available in the Grand Colonial, and must have been brought in from outside. The fridge was transported here from one of the guest bedrooms upstairs.
Oh, nothing else to say about that, huh? Alright, let's check C before I go back. You're walking out of places. We were not in... Wait a second. Okay. Did I double check these? Okay. So we're working on A. I think I'm scaring Ellie. Is that Ellie? Yelling like that? Right, we need the other key card. Is this where the ghostly
timeline discrepancy detected nearby?
The ghostly voice comes from there, I guess? Seems like it could be in that room, actually. Sound like you're gonna tell me to hand over my valuables or something. Keep my hands nice and easy where you could see them or something like that. Spectrum Vodka Red. A3. So A3 doesn't seem to exist as a room. Well, we need to get the key card to that A2. Maybe the chef will have it. Oh, I've been in here. Need to get in there too. Well,
you hear about the murder?
How the hell could I not have heard about it? We couldn't even leave our rooms earlier while security was sweeping for evidence.
Well, maybe you were asleep?
Since management started issuing mandatory caffeinoid supplements, I haven't been able to sleep. It's making it hard to tolerate small talk. Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
No, I'm sorry. We don't serve any drinks with those tiny umbrellas.
Tiny umbrellas. Broken elevator notice. Notice, the Grand Colonial Hotel Service elevator is out of order and will be for the foreseeable future. Please use the stairs to transport all equipment to and from the employee quarters until further notice. Additional liniments will be dispensed for those whose back pain becomes too severe to continue providing the impeccable service our hotel is known for. Sorry, out of order. Warning, workplace injuries affect our bottom line. What wonderful people.
I would...
What?
Get anything good for lunch?
Pea-free nut butter and jelly-free jam on premature bread. Tastes like nothing.
Looks like you win this round. I couldn't afford lunch, so I caught a sprat lurking around crew quarters. Bony, but it's something.
You know those things eat garbage, right?
Good point. I'll try that next if I can't catch any more sprats.
Feed them garbage?
Are you enjoying the amenities?
Or just eating garbage?
Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
Yeah. Patronage, yeah. I understand. Well, can't take any of this stuff.
What the? Oh my law! There's a wasp-keto in my sandwich.
Huh? Whoa, are you alright? You get stung?
Nah, I noticed it before I bit into it. It's dead, thankfully. Still, though, that was... Why are you looking at me like that?
He's hungry.
I mean, are you gonna eat the wasp-keto or not?
Knew it.
If not, I mean, I finished my spread. Just saying.
Wow! I haven't felt this great in ages! I wonder what happened!
You have something coming out of your neck?
Are you enjoying the amenities?
That's not an answer to my question. Mine. Well, at least that stuff I could take. I'll leave the bracelet. Oh, she's got her back turned. I can just take these things too. That stuff. Wow, look at this big cylinder? Canister? Oh, what's that say? Out of order notice. Please excuse our mess. We're working hard to remove all of the valuable treasures our valued guests have misplaced into our pipes. Per usual, items recovered from the sewage inhaler will be auctioned off at the start of the month to employees of the Grand Colonial Hotel. Note that sanitation materials will be auctioned off as well. Happy hunting. Happy hunting. No one running up.
Happy workers lead to happy customers.
Our repeat customers. I think you've got that down. Oh, interesting. I thought the eyes lit up when I selected it. One of those frozen dinners. It's a steal. Right, what's this way then? Oh, this goes out. Out of order. Same note as upstairs. Alright, we'll talk to the chef next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.